suitable for anyone that is pregnant or you have been cleared to exercise postpartum, as well as anybody else. So all people, just like any other exercise, if you feel discomfort or if you feel a bearing down in your pelvic floor, please skip that activity and revisit it at another time. It takes time to learn some different ways to move, so it doesn't always feel the best in your body, so listen to your body, and you know, you can recheck in at another time. Skip that exercise and continue. So we'll begin. I like to sit up on a yoga block. That way I have a nice long spine. And I'm stacking my shoulders right above my hips, bringing my hands to my ribs. I'm going to begin my 360-degree breath. The reason my hands are at my ribs is so I can feel the expansion of my ribs as I breathe. And on the exhale, I feel my ribs come a little closer together and lower. So inhale deeply, feeling that expansion even through the back side of the body, and exhale, the ribs fall back. Inhale and exhale. So this should be a really easy movement. If you feel your body's fighting your rib breathing, take a moment and revisit that another time. So inhaling. On my inhale, I'm fully expanding through the back of my ribs, the front, the sides, getting that nice bucket lift with the ribs. And exhale, lowering. I'm not using my abdominal muscles as I breathe. I'm using just my ribs. My belly may move, and you may see it move, and that's okay. But I'm not breathing into my belly, if that makes sense, or my upper chest. So we're gonna go ahead, after we set up our diaphragmatic breath, we're gonna do some candle's breath with a squeeze. Candle's breath, we're gonna inhale deeply, expanding the diaphragm. Then we'll exhale out of our mouth really slowly, as if we're blowing out 100 birthday candles. So imagine there's a cake in front of you. You're gonna blow out very slowly on that exhale, and you'll feel an upward lifting motion with your pelvic floor, and then also your belly's gonna kind of draw in. What we don't want is a deep sucking in of the belly and pulling the belly tight towards the spine. Let it be easy. Let it be guided by your breath. The ball is gonna help us kind of keep this forefront. So like when we squeeze, we're exhaling, and when we release the ball, we're inhaling. We'll begin on an inhale. And then slowly exhale as you squeeze the ball. Squeeze until your exhale is completely gone, and then begin your inhale. Position. We're going to keep our ball close by, placing the ball or pillow in between our thigh. Our knees are going to be stacked over our ankles. Let's check in with our ribs. A lot of times as we lie down, our ribs just pop out. We're not going to muscle our ribs down, but we're going to find a nice neutral position so that our ribs and our hips are kind of along the same plane. So even if we're lying down, we're stacking our shoulders over the ribs, ribs over the hips. Right? So we're getting that full connection. And you may have to play around a little bit with your hips here. So finding your neutral pelvis, so you're not interiorly rotated and you're not So it's different for everyone. So you may want to wiggle your hips from side to side, front to back, and lead your pubic bone a little bit towards your nose. Getting that little roll forward, but we're not tucking. Placing your arms beside you. We're gonna inhale, lift. Here, we'll begin to squeeze the ball. I'm gonna take that candle's breath with the squeeze. So we're exhaling really slowly out of our mouth. So we'll repeat this 5 more times. So inhaling deeply. And then exhale. Squeeze. Releasing the ball. Inhaling deeply. Exhale, squeeze. Inhaling deeply. And exhale, squeeze. Once again, you're just feeling a lifting action with your belly. It's not a tight pulling in towards the spine. Let it be easy. If you feel any pressure or doming, dial it back a little bit. Maybe not do the squeeze, we can just do the breath. We'll do inhale one more time. And exhale, squeeze. This is a great way to train our deep core muscles. We're strengthening our glutes while we're here. And then we are also, let's lower down. We are also working our lower abdominals. We don't always get a chance to do that. Okay, so from here, we are just going to find our transverse abdominals. And how we do that is we take our hands right beside us. Right beside our hips. We're going to inhale deeply and then exhale slowly. You should feel those muscles kind of rise against your hands. So you know you've activated those muscles. We're going to begin heel slides. Doing 5 on one side and then 5 on the other. Inhaling deeply and then exhale. Sliding one leg out. Inhaling here if you want. Don't hold your breath. So if you feel like you fully exhale by the time your leg has expanded, inhale again. And then exhale. Glide it back. Good. Inhale, exhale, slide the foot away, keeping that engagement. And drag it back on an exhale. Awesome. Inhale. Exhale, engage. Slide. Inhale. Exhale. Slide it back. Inhale. Exhale, engage. Slide the leg away. And exhale, drag the leg back. One more time. Inhaling, and each time we inhale, we're inhaling into our ribs, right? And then we're exhaling slowly and extending the leg. Exhale, drag it back. Let's switch sides. Inhale. Exhale, slide. Inhale. Exhale, slide it back. Our breath, keeping that connection with the muscle. If you lose the connection with your exhale, it's okay. You can always get back to it. So let's do 2 more. Inhale, exhale, slide, dragging the heel back in. Inhale, that deep diaphragmatic breath, and exhale. Slide it away. Exhale, slide it back. Perfect. So now we're going to come to lie on our side. We're going to work on our glute medius. So we're going to come to a sideline position. Our knees are about 90 degrees, or just a little bit more comfortable. You can bring them down a little bit lower. We can place our hand on our belly for some feet feedback if you want, just as in our ribs to see how we're breathing throughout our activity. But all we're gonna do is just lift the top knee. We're not gonna slide back and sit back on our booty. We're gonna stay on that hip, and we're only gonna open as far as the hip allows. So we're not gonna do a big motion like this or rolling back. It's not about how high you can go. We're just strengthening this muscle. These are clamshells. This is working the glute medius. Let's go for 10. And 5, we're halfway. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it down. Let's go for 10 more. 10, 9, 2, and 1. Awesome. So we're done with this side. We're going to internally rotate our hips. So this is important for keeping a nice, well-balanced pelvis. So we're going to internally rotate the hip by bringing the femur closer to one another, and we're going to lift the back heel. We're going to go for 10. Allow this to be easy. Don't force this movement. If it feels a little bit odd to you, take it slow. Let's go for 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Lower down. Let's reset. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring your hands out to the side. We're going to press ourselves up, so we're not going to do a crunch to get ourselves up. We're gonna go ahead and switch sides. Starting with clamshells, we're gonna open up the knee for 10, 9, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. We're gonna lower down. And going for 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Bringing the knees together. We're going to internally rotate. So lifting that back heel. We're going to go for 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. Lowering down. We'll reset. Let's go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome, everyone. We're going to come to lie on our back, back into that bridge position. We're going to release our psoas muscle. So a psoas muscle is a big muscle that holds our lower body and our upper body together, and it runs just along our hips. So what we're going to do is we're going to release that muscle because we hold a lot of tension there, and that'll create a lot of tension in the lower back. It'll prevent us from healing diastasis. If it's really tight, it's pulling on the other muscles in the area. So it's just a great way to balance this muscle. We'll take a yoga block, lifting our hips. We're going to bring that yoga block to our sacrum. So we're going to feel our pelvis fully supported on our yoga block. Yogi's choice, of course, whatever feels good for you as far as the setting of the block. You can do this without a block. So we're going to come up with our leg. We're into a 90 degree tabletop. We're gonna take our palm of our hand and press into our thigh. Then our thigh is gonna press into the hand. So we're gonna set a little timer. Works. And we're gonna hold. Breathing deeply. Find that diaphragmatic breath without losing the tension. Inhale, exhale. Maintaining that tension throughout, and then we're going to slowly lower the leg all the way down. My hip usually gives me a nice little pop when I do this. I'm going to inhale and exhale. Inhale deeply and exhale. Walk the sole of your foot in. Sit up, lift your hips rather, remove yoga block. Another great way to release tension in your psoas is if you have a bolster. If you notice, I pressed myself up, so I didn't do it. I sit up to get myself up off the floor. That's really good for managing pressure, especially if you have diastasis. So if you have a yoga block, you can place it in between your shoulders and just allow your arms to open out to the side. I prefer a bolster because I get up a little bit higher, and I can also just allow my toes to fall from side to side and just breathe into my psoas muscle here as I relax. Taking my diaphragmatic breaths, you may notice in this position your belly may move a little bit more. It's okay. What we don't want to do is just be breathing into our belly all day long, but it's okay to calm your mind and release some tension as well. Another great way to stretch your abdominals is to come into a sphinx pose, which is a yoga posture, and I will show you. You will come down to your belly. Hips are on the mat. You will roll your shoulders back, stacking your elbows, shoulders over your elbows. And you're just going to breathe into your body. Your hands back, get ourselves up, come to seated. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this deep core workout. This was for a workshop that I did, but I have multiple core work little trainings coming up that I will release in more videos, and you can build upon this. Thank you so much for joining me.